Thank you, Mike. And now to that sad weekend story. We've got more details emerging about the helicopter crash that killed Kobe Bryant, his 13-year-old daughter, and 7 other people.
Our coverage begins with Connor Powell, who has the latest on the investigation.
Kobe meant a lot to us all.
The tragic death of Kobe Bryant has sent shockwaves around the world.
It wasn't just what he accomplished, but how he accomplished it.
Fans, friends, and fellow players around the world mourning one of the greatest players ever to grace the basketball court.
It seems like a bad dream.
Bryant, his 13-year-old daughter Gianna, perished along with 7 others when the helicopter they were traveling in crashed in the mountains outside of Los Angeles. The area around the crash is now on lockdown in an effort to keep curious people and paparazzi away. No one is allowed within 5 miles of the site or allowed to fly any lower than 5,000 feet above. Also killed in the crash, Orange Coast College baseball coach John Altobelli, his wife Carrie, and daughter Alyssa. Sarah Chester and her daughter Peyton Chester also died in the crash. The group was traveling to the girls' basketball game in Thousand Oaks, California, at the Mamba Sports Academy. The investigation into what caused the crash is underway.
I guess we'll know in time, but whether it was a fog or whether it was a mechanical problem, but they should have never been flying in that area in the fog.
In Los Angeles, I'm Connor Powell reporting.
And those who knew Bryant are mourning the loss of a good man on and off the court.
Dana Rebeck joins us now with that part of the story. Dana.
And while Kobe Bryant played basketball on the West Coast, he did have a lot of ties here to the Chicago area. And today we had a chance to speak with some of those folks who grew up with him, who coached him, and others who painted his life in pictures.
That's really beautiful. It's special. And obviously right now it's even a little more special.
A commemorative book made by Blue Sky Marketing of Northbrook in 2016 for Kobe Bryant's retirement. 20,000 copies were shipped to LA and handed out to fans during Kobe's last game at the Staples Center.
The most unique thing about the book is it was done with Kobe's family, and they provided some images that weren't otherwise given by the Lakers. And so it became more of a personal book as opposed just a giveaway.
Company founder Elliot Zerlin learned of the tragic passing of the NBA superstar from one of his kids who called him yesterday.
I have a son that lives in Agoura, next door to Calabasas, and he saw it and called us about it. And no one believed it in the beginning, and who would believe it?
News that has been incredibly difficult to process for many, including Northwestern University men's basketball coach Chris Collins.
Tough day in basketball. And, you know, I get emotional because it's someone that I knew very well.
Chris Collins and Kobe Bryant's fathers played together for the Philadelphia 76ers.
I've known him since he was born. My sister and Kobe are about a month apart. And so my mom, I was about 4 years old, and I remember my mom and Kobe's mom being pregnant at the same time.
Collins later went on to coach Bryant on the U.S. national team on 3 different occasions, in 2007 to qualify for the Olympics, 2008 in Beijing, and 2012 in London, a time they reconnected as friends.
Forget about playing basketball and stuff, just the time you're at meals together and talking about kids and family. And I mean, my daughter sent me a picture of her and Kobe at the 2008 Olympics. You know, after she heard the news, and it's just really sad. It's really sad.
And that daughter of Chris Collins, he tells us, also 13 years old. He says this is just hitting way too close to home for him today. And that commemorative book that we just showed you, by the way, going for sale on eBay right now. Bids are up to $350. So definitely becoming a collector's item after
this
tragedy.
I'm sure it'll go higher. Thanks,
yes.
Dana.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Kobe Bryant grew up in Italy. All of his daughters had Italian names. And today, the country is also mourning his death. This picture is Bryant's Canteen Reunite youth team in the early 1990s. It's from Reggio Emilia, Italy. The basketball star moved to Italy when his father, Joe, played for a series of local teams in the 1980s. Kobe spoke fluent Italian and credited the country for the skills he developed on the court. The Italian Basketball Federation says pro teams at all levels will pay homage with a moment of silence in every game this week.
WGN Investigates first reported yesterday that the helicopter that crashed was previously owned by the state of Illinois. It was manufactured in 1991. It was owned by the state from 2000 to 2015, when then-Governor Bruce Rauner put the state's fleet of aircraft up for sale to save money. The helicopter was sold as is with nearly 4,000 hours of flight time on it. It received a fresh paint job, including the Nike logo and Kobe Bryant's signature sheath insignia. After the change of ownership, FAA records show the helicopter had a current airworthiness certificate that was issued in 2015.
And stay with WGN. We have the very latest on the investigation into the death of Lakers superstar Kobe Bryant. Coming up in our next half hour, how the Bulls will pay tribute to Bryant at the United Center tonight. Also, log on to WGNTV.com for up-to-the-minute news, and don't forget to download our free WGN News app.